category of this compound is geometrical isomers are classified as two, in rings and in double bonds. Double bond we are already discussed. Then ring compounds, geometrical isomerism in ring compound. Here the reason, first of all we are discussing what is the reason of geometrical isomerism in ring compound. It is again due to the restricted rotation, but here C, single bond C is the reason for the restricted rotation, because this is ring compound. In ring compound, sigma bond always, sigma bond is the only present, sigma bond is only present in a ring compound, but it also erases some kinds of restricted rotation because it is a ring compound. And mainly it is found to be in cyclopropane, cyclobutane and cyclohexane. So little examples are there. We are dealing with some simple examples: cyclobutane, cyclopropane and cyclohexane. And certain rules are also present, and this will, if we are following this, we get the corresponding ring isomerism, ring geometrical isomerism. The rule number one states that there must be at least two other groups besides hydrogen on the ring. Suppose we are selecting a ring compound. Suppose I am selecting cyclobutane. According to first rule states that there must be at least two other groups besides hydrogen on the ring. And we know that CH2, 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 already one hydrogen is present, or two hydrogen is present in every ring. CH2, CH2, CH2. I can write in this compound as CH2, CH2, CH2. That means every carbon is containing two hydrogen. And our rule states that there must be at least two other groups besides hydrogen on the ring. That means other than hydrogen, some groups are also present in the ring. Next, we are considering cyclopropane. According to our rule states that there must be at least two other groups besides hydrogen on the ring. Suppose every carbon should containing two hydrogen. Other than this, a group must be present. That is the rule number one of the geometrical isomerism in ring. It should contain a groups other than hydrogen. Second rule is these groups must be on different carbon atoms. That means this is carbon one. Suppose I am selecting, this is carbon number one, this is carbon number two, and the two different groups are represent two different carbon also. Then it should satisfy the geometrical isomerism. For example, suppose we can discuss this compound. Look at this compound. My question is, this shows geometrical isomerism or not, this compound? Because it is an example of cyclopropane, which will contain two CH3 groups. And our first rule is correct. There must be at least two other groups present other than hydrogen. That's correct. There must be other two groups. Groups means it should containing two CH3 other than hydrogen. That's correct. It's follow rule number one. But rule number two is these groups must be on different carbon atoms. But here these two groups are present on same carbon atom. That means our rule number two is not following this compound. Then this is not showing any geometrical isomerism. Here two CH3 groups are on the same carbon. This is the carbon and it contains two CH3 group. Then it does not follow the second rule. Then we don't get any geometrical isomerism from this compound. That means this compound is incorrect. This is incorrect. Then we are look at this compound. That means here, this is cyclopropane. I can I'm written the cyclopropane in reverse manner. I can draw the structure in reverse manner, and both are equal. We can draw the cyclopropane in both manner, and something or somewhat this is more genuine or more perfect, or it's a good way to draw the structure of cyclopropane in this way. And here we can observe certain things. It's containing two CH3 groups, and that means it's follow rule number one. And second rule is both groups are on different hydrogen, different carbon atoms, and then follow the second rule also. See, both carbon are different. 1, 2, 3, 1 and 2. Methyl group set, carbon number 1, carbon number 2. Then it's showing geometrical isomerism. And this bolded or thick line represent the bottom face of this compound. The top face is represented as normal line. That means this is projected in space means we can represent this entire structure in a plane of paper. That's why we are thickened this bottom line. Then it's showing this compound is found to be in space, and this is actually the indication of this compound is stereo compound, this thick or bold line. And this is representing bottom face and top face. This is an example of cis-1,2-dimethyl cyclopropane, cis, because both are above the plane. Then what is trans-1,2-dimethyl cyclopropane? Both CH3 are present at opposite faces. I mean, here CH3 at below face, here CH3 found to be at above the plane. Then this position is trans. Then we can call as trans-1,2-dimethyl cyclopropane. Here two CH3 groups are on different carbon atoms. Next example is cyclobutane. It's again example of geometrical isomerism in rings. Okay, this follow both the rules because two methyl groups other than hydrogen, then both are at different carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. We can number this entire compound like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or 1, 2, 3, 4. All are correct, but this is the best way to represent this carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4 and bolded this below face, and this looks like the bottom face and this looks like the front face. Okay, and this compound both CH3 are found to be at above plane. That is, it is called as cis-1,2-dimethyl cyclobutane. Similarly, we can write trans compound. Similarly, we can write trans compound in which both CH3 are found at one is above plane, one is below plane. Then it is called trans-1,2-dimethyl cyclobutane. Again, we get another compound that is called cyclohexane, and in which two CH3 groups are at different carbon atom, 1 and 3 carbon atom, and here both are at same face or above the plane. It is called as cis-1,3-dimethyl cyclohexane, and here this is 1,3 trans-1,3-dimethyl cyclohexane. This is this compound. This is example of trans compound.